Hello, my name is Martin and this is 3D Printing Iceland. In this episode of Makerbox Mondays, I'm going to have a look at a PLA or a HTPLA version 2 Teal from Proto-Pasta. It's a really nice filament, so let's have a look after the intro. So before I start, I want to thank Makerbox for supporting this episode or series. They sent me the Makerbox for the purpose of doing these videos, so thanks to them. But let's have a look at the sticker on the HTPLA. So here on the sticker it says print temperature is 190 to 230, and I normally print this at 225 or 230, the Proto-Pasta filaments. They seem to work great with a little bit higher temperature than normal PLA. And this is called version 2 Teal or Mermaid's Tail Metallic Teal HTPLA version 2. Prints like a great quality PLA, and you can anneal this at 70 degrees for improved temp resistant. And you can get this at protopasta.com. And I printed out a few things and had great results with this filament, so I'm gonna show you those. And of course with a Proto-Pasta filament, I printed out this gnome. It's a Proto-Pasta gnome. It's looking a little bit more blue on the video than it is in real life. It's like a green blue color, so my camera here is not very color calibrated. It's a low detect webcam, but it has some sparkles in it and it looks absolutely awesome. And this is printed at 230 degrees and on my Prusa MK3 printer. This print came out absolutely perfect and no issues, and it looks really nice. And you can see the sparkles, the detail in the model is showing through, and it looks really nice. So this is the Proto gnome. Then I printed out my maker coin, and that also came out excellent and no issues. The letters came out really good, and the face is really smooth, and the letters here in the back really clear and absolutely no issues. And I'm having excellent results with the HTPLA from Proto-Pasta. I'm really happy with this brand. It's one of my favorites. This came out excellent. And then I printed out the Omnum by Tessa. This is an amazing model that I use for the Makerbox samples. This print also came out excellent, and it's really smooth and no print issues and no stringing or any faults. No drooping here in the, I sometimes get a little bit of drooping in this overhang here, but not in this print. So this was coming out excellent, and even the top surface here is really smooth and really nice. And then the Otis model by Gareth. This model is also one of the models I use for my Makerbox samples, and you've seen on my channel. And this came out excellent and no issues. I can see maybe one or two small strands of stringing here in the inside, but nothing too serious. And other than that, it came out really smooth and really nice. No issues. So those were the four models I printed with a HTPLA version 2 Teal from Proto-Pasta. It's a high temperature PLA that you can anneal for better heat resistant. And for those models, I didn't have to do anything like that for them. It's not a structural component. But this filament is looking awesome. It has some glittery factor to it. It's like a really fine particles of glitter with a like green blue or sea green filament, and it looks more blue on camera than it actually does. It's difficult to get the colors right with the cameras I have, but this printed out really easy, and I was printing at 230 degrees on the hot end for this filament, and it came out excellent. Almost no stringing and no issues like that. I would highly recommend that you would go to protopasta.com and have a look at their filament options. They produce the most amazing filaments known to men, I guess. Their looks of the filaments is amazing, so check that out. But for this video, this will be it, and I thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.